London, the memory of a good and much-loved king is honored in Carlton Gardens as the Queen arrives to unveil the national memorial statue to her father, King George VI. People in all walks of life have subscribed to the memorial fund. The statue, in bronze, shows the king in naval uniform and wearing the garter calls her father's wartime inspiration.
He was the living symbol of our steadfastness. He never wavered in his faith that with God's help, the cause of freedom would prevail. And it is fitting that this ceremony should take place on the anniversary of one of the great events in our history as a seafaring nation. When London became the target, he, like so many other gallant Londoners, stayed in his capital and saw bombs fall on his home. There are many who remember to this day the comfort which he and my mother, during their visits to areas which had been bombed, gave to those who had suffered and had lost relatives, friends, and worldly possessions. He inspired great affection by his understanding of young people, which led him, soon after the First World War, to start the camps for boys from all walks of life, at which he took so much joy in sharing in the simple and strenuous pleasures of open-air life. He shirked no task, however difficult, and to the end he never faltered in his duty to his people. And as the first British sovereign to enter the United States of America, he made a signal contribution to Anglo-American understanding. Throughout his life, my father had a deep concern for the welfare of the services, both in peace and war. By his visits to his forces in the field, in Africa and Europe, he brought encouragement to those who had long been parted from their homes and families. With them, he could sympathize. As one who himself enjoyed the blessings of a happy family life, a life founded in Christian faith and perfect love. Today is Trafalgar.